Philip Morris International is an organization operating within the tobacco industry. Their headquarters is located in New York. Currently, 38,000 people are employed within the organization. The current CEO is Louis Camilleri. They have 56 manufacturing facilities, and some of the brands under their name is Marlboro, L&M, and Bonfim. In PMI, the CSI, the code of conduct, where the whole organization has to follow. The code of conduct has priority over everything else in the organization, such as pleasing their shareholders or outdoing their competitors. The code of conduct addresses all the issues associated within the tobacco industry. The code of conduct covers legal aspects, competition, and labor issues.
Philip Morris must be aware that there's a decrease in total consumers since consumers have become more health conscious. In order to become more successful, they'll have to increase their market share to be able to make more profit. Another challenge that they'll face is that there's limitations on advertising due to the Advertising Promotion Act of 2002, which has banned most main forms of advertising. The strength of Philip Morris is their well-known brand of Marlboro, the size of the organization being large, strong distribution channels, and good financial backing and access to capital. However, a weakness that they have is that they have chemicals in the cigarettes such as tar, which leads to lung cancer, and nicotine, which leads to consumers becoming addicted to smoking. Opportunities that they have is in emerging markets and developing countries where they have the chance to establish their brands. A threat that they face is the consumer's health awareness, increased tax on cigarettes, and their competitors.
Philip Morris has more power over the supplier than the new supplier will have to follow the contract's terms and conditions. If not named, it will be terminated. Also, the supplier has to incorporate a mandatory compliance code. However, buyer Philip Morris has a well-known brand, and customers will buy the cigarettes as there is high loyalty towards the cigarette. But consumers are able to buy the same product, which gives them the same satisfaction. Also, another product is an electronic cigarette, which allows consumers to smoke and have no tobacco ingredients, only nicotine. Intensity competition, there are a number of competitors of Philip Morris, and as the tobacco industry consumers are decreasing because of road-conscious consumers, the organization has to increase their market share in order to generate profit with new entrants. There is not much threat from new entrants because the new organization will need a strong distribution channel and high capital in order to operate well.
When looking at the pest analysis, issues such as increase of tax leading to higher retail prices, which then affects the customer's choice. Economical problems that face the company is consumer disposable income. Due to recent cutbacks, consumers need to buy their necessity goods first, which therefore means less money to be spent on cigarettes. Social, culture, and technological problems are linked, as new discoveries from researchers has raised awareness of the health risks linked to smoking tobacco. Consumers are taking this on board and decreasing the amount they buy. The legal regulations, such as health and safety laws, suggest that dealing with tobacco can lead to green tobacco sickness. Therefore, Philip Morris needs to comply with this. The environmental issues faced is that tobacco farms are taking up valuable space which could be used for resources that could benefit the community better.
When looking at the competing values framework, Philip Morris fits into the internal process model, as it has a code of conduct which integrates many factors that affect the business, such as legislation and competition. Philip Morris also has a compliance department in which the chief compliance officer is responsible for overseeing the implementation of the compliance program across the company, working in partnership with the line management and central functions. If everyone follows the code of conduct, it will contribute to the stability and control within the whole organization.
Overall, Philip Morris in relation to corporate social responsibility seems to be doing well. At present, Philip Morris donates to community, helps funds and grants. However, it would be a good idea for Philip Morris to research further into cancer and try using less damaging substance in tobacco.